गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सेमेस्टर सिस्टम ऑफ असेसमेंट, ईयर सिस्टम ऑफ असेसमेंट एंड टर्म वाइज सिस्टम ऑफ असेसमेंट। विद इन द टर्म वाइज असेसमेंट सिस्टम देयर आर वेरियस टाइप्स लाइक मंथली, क्वार्टरली, हाफ ईयरली। हाफ ईयरली इफ वी से देन अगेन इट मीन्स द सेमेस्टर, because a semester is comprised of a time duration of 6 months. Okay, so in total these three type of assessment system we will be discussing. We will see that what are the logic behind implementing these type of assessment system, means why we are implementing some type semester system, some time annual system, or sometime term system like a monthly or quarterly. These things we will be seeing, and side by side also we will see that what are the merit of this type of assessment system, together with that what are the limitation of these systems, because we know that there is no system which is 100% foolproof, means without any kind of a limitation. In fact, when we talk about the system, it is constituted by some of the inherent quality together with the limitations, or better to say that it is their characteristics feature of the system. So that we will be seeing, and we know that education as a system, as a whole system, it is dynamic in nature. Dynamic in nature means that education keeps on changing as per the need, necessity and the demand over the time period. That as per the need, necessity and the demand, we used to keep changing on the different aspect of education. Particularly here we will be seeing only the assessment system, but it may be the curriculum, it may be the syllabus, it may be the contents, it may be the modality of engagement of a learner, that is the pedagogy, even it is the management, which keeps on changing. And the change is based upon one of the thing is that the necessity, and the second is the recent research and development in the area. What the recent researches in that area says about that, what says, and based upon the research finding we used to keep changing this constant part of education. Like that in the assessment sector also, earlier we were having the annual system. Annual system means that assessment will be done at the end of a year, so there will be a 1 year of a gap in the assessment. Okay, so that is the year annual system of assessment. When we talk about the semester system of assessment, then it is at the end of every 6 months, so that one part of a whole education will be in the multiple of 6 months. So suppose that a course is of a 1 year duration, then it will be 2 semesters. Like that the earlier B.Ed and M.Ed program was of a 1 year duration. If it is of a 2 year duration, like that now we have teacher training program and teacher educator programs, so it will be of a 4 semester. Like that when you see that graduate program which is of 3 years, now in the national policy of education it is proposed to be of a 4 years, so it is now of a 3 semester, and as per the new policy, it will be of a 8th semester. So just before beginning of this discussion, that what is the annual and what is the semester system, what are the term wise assessment system, just I would like to know from you that what is your opinion about annual system of assessment and a semester system of assessment, which one is better? Because you people have been educated in the annual system also and a semester system also. When you were in the plus two, it was an annual system. At the end of 11th, you had one exam, that is the final exam. And at the end of 12, you also had one exam. So you have been educated in the both system. Some of you must have completed your B.Ed in an annual system. Some of you must have completed in the semester system also. So what do you think? Which one is better and why it is better? Can somebody tell that? Which one is better and why it is better? As per your understanding. Miss Vijita, yes. So when we see annual system, first annual system, we will see that what are the merits of annual system and what are the limitation of annual system also, because there is a nothing which is limitation less, and everything competes with its own limitations. So we can say that everything with its characteristics features. So when we see the annual system, so within the annual system we find that the time span to study is a more, it is of a 1 year. Okay, so within the 1 year, if we minus some of the vacations or some of the holidays, then also we will get at least 10 month of duration to study the prescribed syllabus. So here the student have a more opportunity to study in depth. They have a more time to discuss. They have a more time to go through the content, consult the library, consult the teacher, consult the peer member, talk, explore the books. So many, for the so many activity, you have a lot of a time. Because the assessment will be done at the end of a year. So you will have a lot of a time to read the related reference books. Suppose that, for example, I will tell that when last year I was teaching philosophy, so therein I was talking about the Paulo Freire, and there I was talking about the Mahatma Gandhi's education philosophy, even Aurobindo education philosophy. So that time when you will find that the discussion in the class was very limited because of the time constraint. And for a better understanding about those philosophies, it is prescribed that you must study the authentic original book. Like that, when we talk about the Paulo Freire's education philosophy, so the book written by the Paulo Freire, one of the very classical and wonderful book is that the Education of Oppressed. So that you must read. When we talk about the Mahatma Gandhi, My Experience with Truth, and the literature available for the basic educations. When I talk about the Vivekananda, when I talk about the Aurobindo, so we must go through the authentic literature related to the content. But due to the semester system, it is not possible to pay much more time to read those books. I'm not saying that your understanding about those philosophies are not in depth, but when you will read those books, then you will understand clearly that in which context those philosophies emerged. Even when we talk about the Rabindranath Tagore and the one of the very prominent philosopher of Orissa, Gopabandhu Das, who is also known as the gem of Orissa. So, in order to understand that why the Gopabandhu was influenced with the Rabindranath Tagore. So, in order to that, you have to understand the anecdotes, the literature. And while reading those literature, very wonderful, one thing I came to know, I was also educated under the semester system. But after completing my course, I was reading the literature related to the Rabindranath Tagore. Then I found that Rabindranath Tagore is not his original name. His name is Rabindranath Thakur. Thakur is the original name. Tagore is not original name. Tagore is the name given by the Britishers because they cannot pronounce Thakur. They were pronouncing Thakur, Thakur, Thakur as if. So Thakur that is became a Tagore. But because it was very easy to pronounce them. Even I have told you several times that go through the one of the again very wonderful book about the problem solving that is written by the George Collier. How to solve it. I'm not trying to point out that you have not read. I know that most of you have not gone through those things. So I'm not trying to point out that. My point of saying is that if there could be a more time, then we could have discussed the some of the important points of those literatures in the class also. I could have given one assignment to read and reflect on those literatures so that you will have a in-depth understanding, better understanding about the context. So that is the one of the advantages when we talk about the annual system. That is not possible in the semester system. Other thing is that in the annual system, we have a lot of time, that's why we have a lot of time for co-curricular activities like a discussion, debate and discussion on the new national education policy 2020. We are used to say new education policy, but actually the education policy 2020 is not named as a new education policy. It is named as a national education policy. So the point of saying that if it is, we have an ample opportunity, we could have discussed that how our national education policy are evolving. What were the characteristic features of the policy 68, 86, revised in the 92, and the final, that is now we have a 2020. So that could have been more fruitful and more better. So this type of opportunity is provided by the annual system. However, it comes with the limitations also. What are the limitations? One of the very important limitation is that here the examination and assessment is neglected because it will come at the end of a year. So assessment will be neglected, and we know that one feature of assessment is that to and one role of assessment is to provide a grade to assess your learning achievement in terms of a learning outcome. But other than that, it is also giving as reflection and a feedback that how the students are progressing, what should be done, what kind of a difficulty they are facing, and what kind of a support they require. And if we will get it, then we can guide them, we can nurture them in a better manner. And then also I find that one of the very important limitation of the annual system is that here the assessment is conducted at the end of a year. So the learning, teaching learning process becomes monotonous, because most of the student, if they are not regularly coming and they are not regular in their study, they think, okay, so the examination will be at the end of year, so now we should not take much burden. And when the examination will come, they will try to mug up, remember rote learning the contents, and they will simply reproduce in the examination and they will get the mark. So whatever we have thought of, that they will get a more time for debate, discussion, going to the library, consulting the teacher, doing for the extracurricular work, will not be transacted if the teacher is not very much active and the students are not very much active. So there is a merit, but they require consistent guidance, consistent planned activities. If the activities are not planned, then it will be very difficult. Whatever the merit is there, those merit will not work. And it is also giving a unnecessary burden for the students as well, when we talk from the student's perspective. Because if it is an annual system, so at the end of year, the question will be asked from the whole syllabus of a year. And even if how much you have understood the content and concept, you require revision when the assessment will be done. And at the end of year, when the assessment will be done, you have to revise whole content. So it may be the burden for the student. It will give unnecessary tension, pressure, and anxiety on the part of the student. I remember when I was in secondary school, that is a 9 and 10. That time, our assessment was done from taking the content of both classes, 9 and 10. Suppose that I am going for assessment of mathematics. So question will be asked from both 9 and 10. 3 hours examination was there, 100 mark examination, and question will be asked from the mathematics content of a 9th and a 10th. Nowadays, the questions are only asked from a content of a 10th. So which examination will give a more anxiety to the student? Obviously the previous one, because the question will be asked from the both classes. Even for the senior secondary also, that is 11 and 12. It was known at that time in Bihar as an intermediate. Even now also it is called intermediate examination. So the question will come from both 11 and 12. So if the longer is duration of assessment, it will give more anxiety, burden on the part of a student. Less the duration of an assessment, it will reduce the pressure. So when the annual system is concerned, it gives a more pressure on the part of a student, isn't it? So in that way, these are the some of the characteristics, features of a annual assessment. Even when we talk about the semester examination, semester assessment. So in the semester assessment, the course content is divided into a time period of a 6 month, multiple of 6 month. Just before I was talking that if the course is of 3 years, then it will be of 6 semester. If course is of 2 year, then it will be of 4 semester. So obviously, the one of the very important feature in the semester system is that it reduces the an anxiety and a burden on the part of a student. The logic is similar. As I just now I was saying, the longer the time duration, it will give a more anxiety. Shorter the time duration, it will reduce the anxiety related to the examination. So this is the added advantage of a semester system examination. Here, the assessment are done more frequently than the annual system. So if the more frequently assessment will be done, then there will be more opportunity for feedback, for reflection, and acting as per the need of a student. So that is the one of the big advantages of having a semester system, that here you have an opportunity to understand the student, to know their difficulty, to know their strength in a better manner, and act as per the necessity. That is the better opportunity is there. Here also, the whole content is supposed to cover within a semester. So teaching learning process goes very rigorously, as just opposite in the annual system. The students were not very much, most of the time they were not very much attentive, because they think that the assessment will be done at the end of year. But here the assessment will be done in a 6 month frequency, semester frequency. So they are more attentive and engaged in the learning process. And if they are attentive and engaged in the learning process, so obviously it will develop the habit of regular study, not at the end of year study and remembering and mugging up. No. It will develop the habit of regular study. And once the habit is developed, then it will be very easy to guide the student. Even the student, they can lead their teaching learning journey. And that is known as the self-regulation. They will be regulated. Their reading learning habit will be regulated. Here also we divide the whole content into two parts, because the assessment will be done at every semester. So the burden of a content is also reduced. One side, it is a rigorous, it is a regular, students are more attentive, students are developing the reading habit, learning habit. And on the other side, the content is reduced. Content is reduced means it is divided into two parts. So when the assessment will come, there will be less content. So it motivates the students also, because content is less, process is rigorous, they are developing reading habit. So the student get motivation due to their achievement, isn't it? And here one thing is also there, that in the semester system, various modality of assessment and delivering a content is emphasized, like assignments, like presentations, oral assessment, field work, this type of modalities are encouraged. So the variety of assessment modalities are possible, and variety of engagement modalities also possible at the same time. But it is not like that there is a no limitation in the semester system. There is a limitation too. The limitations are that here actually student gets a less time for the study. Semester is comprised of a 6 month, but actually we never get 6 month of a time duration for the semester. You must have realized from your own experience, those who have studied in the semester system, those who have not studied under the semester system, you can talk to your friend and ask them that how much time actually they get for the semester system. So there is, they get a less time for a semester system. I am also again emphasizing that even though the content is less, so when we see proportionality, so proportionally, proportion wise also, they are getting a less time. So here the teaching learning process is a very rigorous, which will be a matter of concern for some of the students who are slow learners. Those are the slow learner, for them it may be a matter of concern. Those who learn slowly, because they may not be able to cope up with the time. Again is that we think that it reduces the evaluation pressure on the part of the student. Yes, it reduces, because you are being evaluated twice, and when you will be being evaluated, the content will be less. But again, the frequency of assessment is increased. Not only the two time assessment in a year, but also the variety of assessment modality are prescribed for a semester system. So frequency of assessment increases, and when the frequency of assessment increase, then it will give a unnecessary burden on the part of a student. Since the whole content, it is not like that when we see the syllabus of a year system, annual system, and when we see the syllabus of a semester system. So that in the semester system, the course content will be just half. No, it is not like that. So technically, the content are more when we see in comparison with the annual system, because it is not just half of the annual system. It is not like that. So practically the contents are more. There are more frequency of assessment. Assessment is more regular. So when we talk about the time for the different activity, like that the assessment, like that classroom teaching, like that the co-curricular activities and other thing, it is so tight. Means the time frame is very much packed. And if the time is very much packed, then you will not get a opportunity to explore the other things of your choice of your interest. Like that, just before I was talking that if you want to read the related literature, authentic literature related to the concepts, you may get a less time. Sometimes you may not get a time. So here the point of saying is that time frame is very much packed. When we see in comparison with the annual system, time is very much packed. And if the time is very much packed, then the student will get a less opportunity for exploring the things. So that was the comparative analysis of these two type of assessment, that is the semester system and end-year assessment. Similarly, when we talk about the term-wise assessment, like a monthly and a quarterly. So when we talk about the term-wise assessment, in a month-wise or a quarter-wise, so don't relate the concept as we were relating to the semester wise, because in one semester the one part of a course we complete, but when we talk about the monthly assessment and a quarterly assessment, don't think that in 1 month one part of a course will complete. So like that, in the semester system we were dividing the whole content of a year into two parts. So in the monthly assessment, the whole content of a year will be divided into 12 parts. Or in a quarter, the whole content will be divided into the 4 parts. No. When we talk about the term-wise assessment, like a monthly or a quarterly, it is to improve the frequency of assessment to understand the student. And those assessment will need not be a paper pencil test always, like a monthly assessment. It need not be a paper pencil test always. Sometime it may be paper pencil test, sometime it may be oral, sometime it may be project assessment, sometime the group work, sometime co-curricular activities. So when we talk about the monthly and a quarterly assessment, the main motive is to understand the student, to get familiarity with the student, their problems, their difficulty, what kind of a support they require. Okay, so that was all about the annual system of assessment, semester system of assessment, and term-wise system of